Hi, my name is Damien. Welcome to RepTV. In this episode, Media Lab covered the 2015 RP Open House, where prominent ministers walked through the various booths set up by our very own students. Let's take a look at the video.
House kicked off on 8 January 2015 with the arrival of Education Minister Mr. Heng Swee-keat to grace the event.
Together with RP Chairman Mr. David Wong and RP Principal Mr. Yeo Li Piao, Mr. Heng and entourage made their way through 42 booths representing RP 6 schools and 1 centre, mingling with staff and students along the way. This year's open house did not disappoint, with many interactive booths featuring the best of what each diploma in RP has to offer.
The polytechnics education has a more hands-on, practical, applied learning focus. And as I spoke to many of the students, they are actually very enthused by this hands-on approach. Now, the JC curriculum is more academic in nature and more theoretical. And so some students may enjoy the more academic content, some may enjoy the more applied hands-on learning.
The afternoon saw another milestone for RP when Parliamentary Secretary for Ministry of Health and Transport, Associate Professor Muhammad Kaijal Ibrahim, unveiled the new RP Khoo Teck Puat Teaching Dispensary.
This is the first and only teaching dispensary in Singapore, set up in collaboration with Khoo Teck Puat Hospital. With more than 600 types of medicine stored here, students get to learn how to manage a pharmacy in a real and authentic setting.
The dispensary will be a welcome resource for the students in the Diploma of Pharmaceutical Sciences in RP.
I think that by learning in such an environment, because it's exactly the same as a local hospital, so we are working in the same industry, so we know what the industry needs as we practice in the same dispensary format.
We are one of those first few polytechnic who has such facilities, because this facility actually serves as a very good background for students to learn hands-on skills to prepare them for the industry, particularly in the pharmacy practice areas.
The RP Open House was held for 3 days and saw a record number of 5,500 visitors.
Ever heard of Master Chef? Well, how about iChef, a competition held for secondary school students by RP's very own School of Hospitality. Watch these young chefs cook up a storm.
The heat was on in Republic Polytechnic's very own Oliver restaurant on the 12th of September. 10 secondary schools competed in the School of Hospitality's iChef finals. Teams had to prepare a 3-course meal from traditional family recipes, which was the theme for this year's competition.
I think they learned to be more independent, and they learn teamwork as well, because they need to bring together each of their own family recipes and how to work together as a meal.
Before getting into the kitchen, teams were given a budget of $50 to shop for their ingredients, which gave a few teams setbacks in their recipes.
And now we actually have to change some of our recipe just because of one or two ingredients.
The team still managed to rough it out. After preparing their meals, they had to present their course to a panel of judges. The winners of the competition were Team Cereal from Yenching Secondary School. Even though other teams did not win, they came out with skills they can apply in the future.
Forget about award attendees dressed in elegant gowns and suits. Create IG held the Flame Awards with a very special twist to their theme. Heroes and villains, flaming hot.
This is your emergency broadcast system announcing the commencement of the annual purge. At the siren, all crime, including murder, will be legal for 12 hours. All emergency services will be suspended. Your government government thanks you for your participation.
Well, I'm supposed to be Penguin from Batman. What inspired me is because I like to tell people what to do, and when there's danger, I usually run away. And Penguin does that very well, so I'm like, gonna be that guy. Yeah.
Actually, I'm looking forward to the performances, whether they are in their own superhero or villain's costume. Like, it'll be nice to see like very diverse costumes like performing.
I think like the guy who wore the Sailor Moon thing was quite cool, and then he somewhat danced in the dress, yeah. And like Supergirl also was also quite cool, yeah.
This is really overwhelming for me, for us, because we actually didn't expect for this simple outfit to actually win the outstanding outfit for the award, so it's actually very good for us and very overwhelming, so it's very very good.
We have finally come to the segment Reflections With. What does it take to be Singapore's best sportsman? RepTV talks to the former Singapore football captain Fandi Ahmad, and he shares with us his definition of success, not only in sports, but in life.
Good evening, Coach. Thank you for taking the time to appear in our student-run RepTV Reflections With. So today we'll be featuring you, Mr. Fandi Ahmad. So you have been made a mark as a professional footballer, be it locally and internationally. So we want to know, what's your definition of success?
The meaning of success for me, it comes in many platforms, many ways, because I believe a true success comes from individual team, or not team sport, it's individual player. But for me, I always see it as a team effort. Not only me, the success, I always believe I share with everybody that is achieved by winning the game, and as well as performing to the highest level. And I always like to leave a mark.
So recently, Madame Tussauds made a wax figure out of you. Is that like also like a mark of success for you?
I remember asking them, why do you choose me? I said, the public wants you to be there because it's just come from a voting from the people in Singapore. I feel humble, you know. I've done nothing for the country. I just play football. My main thing is to entertain, because I believe I have a gift from God, which I must give back. So by giving back in the football field, I believe I unite a lot of people of many races. And for me, football is a value of life for me. For other people, I'm not sure.
So we're very sorry to hear about your father's passing away. So is it okay if we ask you about this question? Because during that period of time, Singapore suffered a really huge controversy to the loss to Malaysia. It was a very controversial thing, and the press covered it. And we just would like to hear you on your thoughts about the match.
I wasn't feeling good because Dr. Meras made decision after 7 weeks. My father was in hospital. I had few tickets, so on that night, I gave it away. I said, I don't think I'll be going for this game. So I give it away, and next morning I had training, so I asked my brother and my wife to go. So suddenly he passed away that morning. So I wasn't there, but I came in later. So I was a bit, of course, sad that Singapore lost, but I was more sad when I heard the news in the morning. I had to rush there, and he passed away on the 29th, we lost. So for me, I can feel something's happening, you know, because the day before, I don't feel good to go for the game. So, but he's been my inspiration for ages, since I was young, get me training with the boys, yeah.
Your late father was a national footballer, and you're also a national footballer. So how important do you think family support is?
Sports, only one chance, two chances maximum. But studies is every day until you're 60 years old. So I'm not saying you must quit school, not saying you must quit sports. If you can balance both, that's very important, where the parental support is so important for you. Can you go further in sports? Can you be a professional footballer or tennis player or swimmer? If you think you can, I say you must pursue it, because once in a lifetime, coming from a red dot, small country like Singapore, it makes history. That's what I think is a real success story. La, 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 la.
That's all we have for the 8th episode of RepTV. We hope you liked it. For more stories, you could check out republicanpost.sg. My name is Damien. Stay tuned to our next episode.